Hello friends, welcome to this session. In this session, we will see how you can use Azure Storage Explorer to connect to your storage account and then access those blob containers or file storage or the table storage. As you can see here, when you log into portal, I have already created a storage account here, connect to storage account, and within this account, I have created blob container, connect to blob storage. I also have file storage file share here, Conto file storage, and I also have a table storage, Conto table storage. Now all these different types of storage, you would like to access them using Azure Storage Explorer, for which you should download this Storage Explorer from Microsoft site, and it comes for Windows, Linux and Mac. Once you download and install it, then when you invoke Storage Explorer, it looks something like this. Now here, there are different ways you can connect your Storage Explorer to the storage account. We'll see. So if you right click on storage account, see the option of connect to storage account. Click on this. And Azure environment, you select Azure. There are these three different options. You can use a connection string or use a shared access signature, or you can use storage account and the key name to connect to storage account. So we'll see all these three and figure out how we can easily connect. So first we'll start with use a connection string. Select this, go next, and give a display name. So we can say Conto storage and the connection string. Now this connection string, you have to go back to the portal and go to your storage account. Under access keys, you will see here the key one. This is connection string here, this one. So copy this connection string and then paste, next, connect. And you can see now it shows all different types of storages here, blob and the container in that, and the file storage, the table storage. So all are accessible. So this was the method to connect using connection string. You can easily detach so that it's no more connected now. And then now we'll try to connect using some other method. So again, now we'll see, we'll use shared access signature URI. So select that, next, again display name. So we'll give on to storage and it asks for URI. Now, and then you can see it will ask for blob endpoints, file endpoints, table endpoints. Actually what happens for each of these storage services, endpoint is published, which you can use and make calls to the REST API. So we'll go back to portal, and this time on the left side you will see here shared access signature. So click on this, and on the right side will give you so many options. So it allows you to create SAS for blob, file, queue or table storage services. If you select all of them, then using that SAS all will be accessible. So I will keep it as default, but you can actually select one of them as required. All resource types, whether service, container or object, what type of permission you want to allow on this, read, write, delete, update, and time based, because you can say from when it starts and up to what time and date it is allowed. I'll leave it default. This is just for a day, one day around. And you can also say whether HTTPS or HTTP, which type of protocol it should follow. Once you generate SAS and connection string, it will give you all those endpoints. So you see this SAS token here. This has to be appended with each of the endpoints whenever a request is made. Based on this, the permissions will be provided to the user who wants to access that type of service. Now we will copy this. Every storage service has its own URL to access. If you see, the difference is only this part where the storage account name dot, whether it is blob or whether it is a file or a queue or a table. So based on that, it figures it out which service it has to access. So we'll copy this SAS token and paste it here, and it says no protocol provided. So if you go at the beginning, it's missing the part of URI. So here what we can do, we can pick any one of, let's say a blob endpoint, and we copy this and add it to beginning. The moment you do it, automatically updates the rest of the endpoints, and it knows that it has to append this hash. So once this is done, say next and then connect, and you can see it has again provided access to the block container, the file storage and the table storage. So it's that easy to connect to your storage account. So we'll detach this again and we will now try the third method. So connect to Azure storage and we'll use the storage account name and key. This one is the easiest one. So give a name and it asks for account name. Now if you go back to a portal, on the left side click on access keys again, and here you see it's a storage account name. Copy, provide this, and then account key. Account key is nothing but these keys, key 1 and key 2. So copy the one of the key, next, and connect. And you can see again your blob, your file and your table storage is accessible. I hope this will help you guys, and thank you so much for watching this session.